I really want to talk to you about the President of the United States and his fascination with dictators around the world. The latest example here, the repressive regime in Saudi Arabia, headed by King Salman and Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. It was no accident that President Trump's first foreign trip was to a country that rolled out the red carpet for him in more ways than one. In fact, it was organized by Jared Kushner, a close friend of the Saudi prince. And now President Trump is going out of his way to buy the Saudi story about what happened to missing journalist Jamal Khashoggi, even while the Saudis are trying to get their story straight right now. Sources are telling CNN that the Saudis are preparing to report that a report that will say that Khashoggi is dead, the victim of an interrogation gone wrong during an attempted abduction. But is even that the truth? How do we know if that's even the truth? I mean, after all, the Saudis have been swearing up and down that Khashoggi left the consulate, even though there's closed circuit TV of him entering, but no sign of him leaving. Now they're apparently changing their story in the face of outrage from around the world. But the president, he got his own theory.
It sounded to me like maybe these could have been rogue killers. Who knows?
There is absolutely no evidence of that. But for President Trump, it doesn't seem to matter whether the facts support what the Saudis say. What matters is that they deny it strongly.
I just spoke with the King of Saudi Arabia, who denies any knowledge of what took place with regard to, as he said, his Saudi Arabian citizen. I've asked, and he firmly denied that. The king firmly denied any knowledge of it, but his was a flat denial. All I can do is report what he told me, and he told me in a very firm way that they had no knowledge of it. He said it very strongly. His denial to me could not have been stronger, that he had no knowledge, and it sounded like he and also the Crown Prince had no knowledge. The denial was not only a denial, it was a very firm denial.
And last night he told Leslie Stahl this.
As of this moment, they deny it, and they deny it vehemently. They deny it. They deny it every way you can imagine.
So the question is, think about it. Why is this president so eager to take the word of the leader of a repressive regime? Simple. It's all about the deal.
I tell you what I don't want to do. Boeing, Lockheed, Raytheon, all these I don't want to hurt jobs. I don't want to lose an order like that. There are other ways of
punishing,
to use a word that's a pretty harsh word, but it's true.
Punishing is a harsh word. I'll tell you another harsh word. Murder. A lot of Americans would agree that a regime that murders a U.S. resident should be punished if the crime is proven. But I want you to listen to what President Trump says about another dictator, Kim Jong-un.
He presides over a cruel kingdom of repression, gulags, starvation, reports that he had his half-brother assassinated, slave labor, public executions. This is a guy you love.
I know all these things. I mean, I'm not a baby.
I know
all these
things. Why do you love that guy?
Look. I get along with him, okay?
But you said love him.
Okay, that's just like a figure of speech.
No, it's like an embrace.
Well, let it be an embrace. Let it be whatever it is to get the job done.
He's a bad guy.
Look, let it be whatever it is.
I'm not a baby. Whatever it takes to get the job done. And those strong denials from the King of Saudi Arabia, let's see. Where have I heard that before? Oh, yeah.
I have great confidence in my intelligence people, but I will tell you that President Putin was extremely strong and powerful in his denial today.
A strong denial certainly seems to get this president's attention, whether you're accused of sexually assaulting underage girls, like Roy Moore.
He says it didn't happen, and, you know, you have to listen to him also. You're talking about... He said 40 years ago, this did not happen.
Or you're accused of domestic abuse like Rob Porter.
as you probably know, he says he's innocent. And I think you have to remember that. He said very strongly yesterday that he's innocent.
Or whether you're accused of financial crimes like Paul Manafort.
Manafort has totally denied it. He denied it.
Well, that guilty plea put a damper on the president's fondness for Manafort. But this president doesn't trust everybody.
I don't trust everybody in the White House. I'll be honest with you.
He trusts dictators around the world, but members of his own administration? Apparently not so much. Not if they disagree with him. The Trump doctrine seems to be pretty simple. Anybody who sides with me or him is okay, no matter what they do. And anybody who doesn't is his enemy, is my enemy. All's fair as long as you win. Winning is all that matters to this president. Listen to what he said about Christine Blasey Ford.
Do you think you treated her with great respect?
I think so, yeah, I did.
But you seem to be saying that she lied.
You know what? I'm not going to get into it because we won. It doesn't matter.
Well,
we won.
It doesn't matter. We won. You won't find a clearer statement of the Trump doctrine than that. That and never apologize. Even after Elizabeth Warren released DNA results that indicate she has some Native American heritage.
You owe her an apology?
I owe her. She owes the country an apology.
So don't apologize. Double down. But here's the thing. As we say here on the show all the time, facts do matter. Facts matter. It matters what happened to Jamal Khashoggi. It matters what Vladimir Putin did during our presidential election. And what he may do again. It matters what Kim Jong-un does. So what happens if President Trump gets to a point where he needs to rein in these dictators to protect Americans, to protect the free world? Does this president have any leverage left? Or has he left it all on the table and made a deal with the devil?